Hello, hello. Welcome to the... Hello? Hello? Yan. Welcome to the first ever Hearthstone Battlegrounds community party tournament in Philippines. I'm Enly and CaraCute will be here to assist us and give insights on the current happenings on the battlegrounds. So, apologies for the 15 minutes delay, and we're also running a delay to avoid sniping if there will be something that happens like that. So now we're on the I'm presenting you the players, the 8 players. CaraCute will describe them. Who are they?
Yes, good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. So, for everyone tuning in, again, this is the first tournament, of course, sponsored by AKG Games. And we're giving away a $100 worth of Blizzard balance to the top 3 players out of this 8. So, who are these 8 players? Okay, let's start actually with the highest. Actually, the poster is actually from the highest MMR to the lowest one. So, the first one that we have here is Mapo. So, Mapo, highest MMR out of all the participants with 12,000, give or take, plus minus. So, yeah, currently is the highest right now. Second one is Weatherlight, with around 11,000 MMR. Then, rest of the players is Switch. Of course, Switch, very popular Hearthstone player as well. Winner of the Hearthstone Taipei yeah, Masters 2.
Two years or three years ago.
Yep. And also participated in the first team challenge, right?
Yes.
Team captain, where Enly and their team Enly won. So he's going to play again, but this time is solo queue. Then, who's next, Enly?
So, next is Oiger, one of the community player in Excelsior/Channel 8 Friday Night Battlegrounds duel. I lose already to Oiger one time at the final, so I bet he's a great player. Next is JudeQuinn, one of the content creator in Battlegrounds in Philippines.
Yep.
Not sure if he already played other Battlegrounds tournament, but with his experience in creating contents, maybe that will transcribe on winning him a tournament now. The next one is daiske. Daiske and Grappha, actually, I'm not sure if they're competing in the...
I think they're just new. It's the first time actually I heard of the two
players. Hello? I think Kara is lagging, but...
These two names?
Yeah. See, but Daisuke is already at my friend list, so what? Maybe he already competed in a standard tournament, but I'm not sure if he competed on...
Daisuke and haven't...
Oh. Kara, your audio is stuttering. I'm not sure why. But... It's not...
Yeah, can you hear me now?
Yeah. Earlier, it's stuttering. And it's not continuous.
Okay. Sorry. I think my PC lagged.
Okay,
so
okay.
Anyway, yeah, these two players, what I'm saying is these two players, Daisuke and Grappha, are first time I saw these two battle tags joining any competition. So this tournament is a good way to for them to, you know, get to know them from the community.
Yeah, that's
they
true.
Will know these two players. So their MMRs are pretty around 8,000 for both players. So already, I think, yeah, they're here in the top 8, so that means it's above average of the normal MMR of the Hearthstone players.
And if we translate the 8K MMR, it's almost legend in standard, right? Because it's hard to get 8k. Then 10k is like top 500. So our next player is Daddy Oni. He's competing in a lot of tournaments, BG Standard. He's been one of the tourney goers for our community tournament. So he's the least, he's the lowest MMR among them all, but I know he can play a good BG. So let's root for all these 8 players and hope that they will show a good match. 4 rounds of Battlegrounds. And the point distribution is as follows. You can see in the stream, there's slight deviation from the usual 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're giving away the top 2 much more, what you call it, importance, with 9 points and 8 points, followed by 3rd to 6th, 3rd to 5th, with 6 points, 5 points, and 4 points, and while for the 6 and 7, 2 points and 1 point. And the last will get 0. So, hopefully, if one of the players get to first, they shouldn't get 8 on the next round. So, they won't have a hard time getting to the top 3. We won't have, as much as possible, we won't have a tiebreakers if that happens, because we have a tiebreaker rule. Assuming that there's the top 3 get a, what you call it, a tie, the first tiebreaker would be the most number of first place, while the second tiebreaker is the least number of 8th place. So we'll be seeing a the most consistent among these 8 players to get the top 3 spot. Kara, do you have anything else to
very
say?
I'm very excited, actually. I'm very excited to see who will get the, who will win the first place. Is it the highest MMR players, or will the other players, you know, upset underdogs? Will upset this high ranked MMR player? So I think I've explained all the rules. So I should.
Oh. Wait. I think the category is.
Wait. Grappha is an OW feeder. What is an OW? Is it Overwatch?
Maybe.
Sorry, the chat has like 3 minutes delay, so we'll answer your questions a little bit delay. But let me just check in the players if they're ready. But today we're actually, the stream is quite unique because we're going to do dual stream.
Yeah, that's true.
We're going to do dual stream, so we're going to view 2 screens.
So for the first round, we'll be viewing Mapo on the left, and on the right will be Weatherlight. So let's talk about the new patch, Kara, while we're waiting for our players. Have you played the 3 new heroes already?
Yep, I have been playing Battlegrounds lobbies with the Hearthstone community, with the friends. So I had the chance to try out those new heroes, especially Jandis, very good with pogos, and I think it's really a good hero. And then Barov, it really depends if you like to gamble with who wins. So yeah, it's quite fun as well.
Just for sharing my experience, we played the launch of the Battlegrounds party, and I played Lord Barov. I wager from the very start of the game, from round 1. But unfortunately, for 7 rounds, I only won once. And after round 7, I already died in the lobby. I just played for fun, not for competitive. But yeah, that's true. What's this? Jandis is super strong with Pogo build. And during that game, last time, I played it with Murloc build, so Primal Fin Outlook, I'm just cycling it, so that's one more way to play it.
I think the Battlegrounds is actually the Battlegrounds lobby is actually very good to, you know, just try fun compositions, trying the new heroes because doesn't lower down your MMR, right? So
yeah,
can, that's what we're doing in the past couple of days, just playing different strategies, different builds, so we can learn more. So doing it with friends is actually convenient because there's no drop in the MMR if you're concerned with the MMR, of course.
How about Omu? Have you played Omu already?
Yeah, I tried Omu. It's also good if you have tokens. So if you got token start, then you can play Omu turn 1, turn 2, you can hero power sell by, right? So that's I think it's good also, the Omu. One of the top 3, if I'm not mistaken, of the top 3 heroes right now in Battlegrounds.
So our players are assembling themselves in the lobby already. We'll be starting in maybe 2 minutes if they confirm that they're already ready. Are you guys excited to witness this first ever lobby party in the Philippines? It's hard to speak in English, you know, Kara.
It's okay. Let's see what will happen in the. I think the very first lobby is the most exciting part because we will see if the players will play safe. Players will play for top 4 or go for top 1, and some interesting builds we'll see. So I think we're starting.
Yeah. So I'm switching to the tournament screen now. So we'll see if we could jump into the party. Weatherlight is not accepting my request.
Okay. Actually, I'm now spectating Weatherlight. So, Weatherlight is using Kael'thas. So, Kael'thas is actually a pretty strong hero. Probably one of the higher tier heroes. And we have Mapo, one of the best heroes as well, using the Maiev. So those two which we are spectating is actually both using good heroes. And Daddy Oni with the Yog switch using Nosdormu, so also good. JudeQuinn with Shudderwalk. Oiger with George the Fallen. Interesting to see what are the other options for Oiger, why he end up selecting George. And the last two, Daiske is in Millhouse and Lich King. Ever since the buff for Lich King is also one of the best heroes in Battlegrounds recently. So yeah, we'll see how it goes.
We have to take into account that there's no beast in the lobby.
Actually, there is beast.
Really? Wait.
Yeah. The one that's not here is pirates. So there's no pirates.
Okay, sige. So okay. There's no pirates.
There's no pirates. We have that caption there. Change it to no pirates.
Changing it now. So Weatherlight. It's not being spectated.
Actually, I can't spec Mapo's board right now. But I'm only seeing.
Ask him to invite you.
So, Kael'thas here. Using to buff the Righteous Protector, which is very good because it gives plus Divine Shield and 3-3 stats. So this will end up a tie with Mapo. Didn't see what Mapo did on the first few rounds. If he did hero power or he did via minion. And did you see the Mapo?
No. I'm busy on changing the overlay, but now I can watch them simultaneously.
Right. So.
So I think Mapo started with I think he started with hero power and without token. That's why he's at 36 health. Because he took 3 damage.
Ah, okay. Let me restart my other Hearthstone.
So the what I'm experiencing in Spectate right now is that most of the time I'm always kicked out on the lobby. I'm not sure why, but I can re-enter. So I'm watching now Weatherlight. Weatherlight is already at by phase. That's fast.
Weatherlight is actually at 28 life. That's super low. So I don't know why, but this lobby is pretty strong with the best minions like Lich King, Maiev,
yeah,
Nosdormu.
It's like an aggressive lobby because aside from Oiger, right? A late game hero with George the Fallen.
Yep. So now, Kael'thas still choose to, of course, level up because he wants to. But Shadowwalk is playing against Shadowwalk, but Shadowwalk still at level 2. Probably, but he's on the Murlocs build, so I'm thinking he's going on the Pogo build since he's still on tier 2. But Murlocs is also one of the best builds for Shadowwalk. You don't need Bran.
Yeah, as for Mapo, he goes wide, but he'll be fighting Daddy Oni with Yogg-Saron. So I'm expecting Mapo to lose here in this round, taking maybe 5 damage. It's been 4 rounds, I think, and Mapo is not hitting a triple yet. So it's hard for Maiev to scale that pass without the triples, right?
Actually, yeah, I can see Mapo now. I have 2 screens. Okay, let's see. So they are both in the recruit phase now, right? Both Mapo and it's turn 6 currently. So for Weatherlight here, looks like he's giving up on the. He's giving up on the pair. I think he will both sell this pair because it's been several turns, but he hasn't gotten any triples yet. So usually when you don't hit your triples like 2 or 3 turns already, you just give up.
Yeah, and especially in the late and the early game. It's hard to hoard for triple.
Yep. So very good strategy actually for Weatherlight here, deviating, selling the pair and then going for the jugglers. Can selling of course the 3-4 to boost the stats +1/+1 to all, and then buying the imprisoner with the soul juggler. I think he can win this pretty easily. Now looking over at Mapo, who's playing the Lich King.
Lich King is Grappha.
I see, okay. So, Lich King is still perfect. I mean, still undamaged until now. And looking like this is a win for Lich King as well.
Mapo's board, as I've said earlier, this round is kind of weak. He's not hitting his triple, so that's kind of bad for Maiev.
So, let's do a quick recap here on the standings right now. So, Grappa still at 40. still at 40, now at tier 4, and Daddy Oni, who's also at 40, choosing to go to Tavern 5. So, looks like his board is really strong. The rest of the Abby are still in Tavern 4 and 3. Yeah, the lowest is Tavern 3.
So now Mapo is facing a Tavern 4 daiske with Milo's Mana Storm. I'm not sure if the Mana Storm is kinda strong right now, but it's gonna be crucial for Mapo. He needs to tie this up or win this.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't notice Mapo is now at 12, so kind of very low now. I don't know why what happened to Mapo, why it's very low now. Currently, there doesn't have any triples yet. Also, Kael'thas. When we're spectating, Weatherlight doesn't have any Kael'thas as well. So, both of them doesn't have any triples yet. So, once Mapo loses, we might switch to probably Grappa here.
Yogg-Saron is at 5 win streak. Lich King is at 3 win streak. So, if our two boys fall in this lobby, we'll jumping to Lich King and Yogg-Saron.
It's a win. So Lich King will get his first damage. This is around 10. Okay, that's quite big. So for Kael'thas here, for sure, I think he will just level. No. Let's see.
No, he'll buy. Sell buy.
But he's still he's thinking to level here. I think he's thinking what are his options because he's seeing he's up against Mapo is actually very low, meaning he has very weak board. So, can either level here or... I think his board is pretty strong already. But I don't know what to sell. He's just choosing to... Oh, it's a triple. Triple Imprisoner. So, this is Weatherlight's first triple of the game. It will buff the Sorrelisk as well.
Yeah, Bran. So it's looking that Weatherlight will have a good following rounds, assuming he won't take lethal damage here. And I'm assuming he won't take lethal damage because, as we can see, Mapo is not that strong for a round 7. This is round 7 already, right?
Let me check. Yeah, turn 8 now. It's turn 8.
Okay, turn 8. So apologies if the stream is lagging. It's kind of hard for my CPU to handle two clients and Kara's face.
Yeah, I think it's the stream is lagging.
Okay. Maybe I could remove Google Chrome.
Meaning because Weatherlight decided to hold this Bran and Twilight Emissary. So he wants to save resource for the next turn. He doesn't want to waste gold. And
the double
probably thinks that he's still strong. Okay, so he's not still leveling this turn. He's playing it safe.
And he's showing how to play Menagerie, right? This is how you play Menagerie.
So he's for sure going to buy this Vermin Sensei. And this Annoy module looks also good. And for sure, the Shredder on hand is just going to keep it or for possible triples later on. But the problem with this is going to have only 6 minions or it's gonna play already the Shredder. Okay, so for this one, actually, he chooses to buff the Annoy module because it's... basically, will add +2/+2, so it's good. That's why you chose to just buy the Hound Master first and freeze the board.
So
for Mapo here, yeah, go ahead, Enly.
So for Mapo, I think he could survive against JudeQuinn here. And I'm checking my specs right now. If CPU is overloaded, yeah, that's 100% usage. Wait, I have to look for something to remove. I tried this already 2 days ago with dual stream ladder, but without Discord call. So I think the Discord call makes this lag.
Can we just call in the cell phone?
But there won't be no face for you.
yeah, right. So,
but we could try without your face first. Without your face, remove your camera.
So Weatherlight here actually hitting the triple now with the piloted shredder. So that's actually very good for him and very good chance to another Bran or strong shell is also good. Okay, so he went to strong shell because strong shell is good with the Bran as well. It gives you +4/+4 stats. So actually it's very surprising for Weatherlight to stick at tier 4, but
maybe that's the reason why he's sticking in tier 4 is that there are a lot of buffers there with the what do you call it? That gives +2/+2 to 3 tribes. That's tier 4, right?
But I'm thinking here, I think it's just trying to finish maybe on top 4 or something because it's actually the minion that is trying to buff is not game, I mean not for late game, but it also depends on how much buffs he gets. So here, you choose to freeze the board. He's going to buy the... Why is he freezing the board? Is it for the 2/5? I'm not sure, actually. Oh, going to Mapo! Lich King is now at 5. I didn't even notice.
Yeah, from the first time losing to Weatherlight, right? Down to... Yeah. To this.
Wow. Oh, so is he dead?
Lich King is dead. Lich King is dead. Because Mapo have a lot of refresh for his Deflectobot. And our bottom two earlier is surviving and dealing little damage to our other 6 players. So Lich King is now officially dead. He's getting 0 points on this round.
Oh, medyo bumalis na yung stream, Enly. So I think that... Did you close the camera?
No. I didn't close.
Okay, so what did you close?
Nothing.
So actually, what Enly mentioned, Grappha is on 8th place, so that will be 0 points for him. And we're seeing Mapo versus George, so
maybe,
George is actually very low as well, 3.
Yeah, there will be one casualty or two this turn. Because Kael'thas, Weatherlight is facing switch at 14 health with dragons. I'm not sure if the dragons are big enough to handle this big Hydra and big piloted shredder on Weatherlight's board. Also, a big imprisoner.
Actually, this board from Weatherlight is very strong. I think he's still thinking if he wants to freeze the warden for the pair, but maybe no.
And if you can see, Mapo having an unstable ghoul tech there because he's facing George and he wants to kill the George. But apparently, George is at a demon comp, so it's kind of big. And there's another divine shield popper. Giver with golden selfless zero. So I'm thinking that Mapo will lose here. Even with that unstable ghoul tech.
And that selfless hero sniping the other mechano. So looks like Switch is having the Kael'thas build and it's very strong now. Dealing 11 damage to Kael'thas. So okay, 2 out. Mapo is out at 7th place and JudeQuinn at 6th place. And
so I'll move to daiske since he's the one on the lead. But I think daiske is on no spectate mode.
Me too, I can't spectate. So probably let's
jump to Switch. Oh no, Switch is also on a no spec mode. I think we'll jump to Daddy Oni. They're shy. Why? They should be proud of themselves.
Mapo getting 1 point there and the other guy, JudeQuinn, getting 2 points, right? And
Lich. Yeah, 2 points.
So our number one ranked MR player is now down. So exciting to see who will get this first lobby. Kael'thas is actually facing Mapo, is actually a ghost. So it's a good, maybe he tavern up, didn't so, but he still didn't tavern up, so he's taking a tavern 4. So this strategy is, actually haven't tried this strategy before, staying at tavern 4 for like, you know, 6 turns already. So Weatherlight's probably using this strategy for this kind of menagerie build.
Yes, that's true. So staying at a good tavern and just buff up his board. So I jumped to Oiger because I cannot spectate Daddy Oni also. So Oiger of playing George. And still Weatherlight playing Kael'thas. For next round, Kara, I'll remove our beautiful faces on this on the stream and will be shown on the scoreboards only. Okay?
Sure. Okay. So now, Kael'thas is actually in top 4. Who are you spectating only on the left side? Sorry.
Oh, Oiger. George.
Oiger. Okay. And Daddy Oni fishing 5th.
So Weatherlight's facing Oiger and Weatherlight didn't find a stable ghoul. So probably Weatherlight will lose this turn. So one of our window will be changed again. Daiske is at 24 health, sitting pretty at Tavern 5 with 3 goldens. Actually, Oiger hit 5 goldens. That's why he's kind of strong. And the reason why he He's at one health. He played a demon build, right?
Ah, okay. I see. Haven't played much George, but looks like this strategy, I mean, this type of build he does play with this hero, George. Like what I've said earlier, I'm curious what are the other choices for Oiger, why he chose to select the George. Okay, that's actually quite big, popping the Divine Shield. Killing the Hydra.
Have you seen the Mana Storm board? Not yet, right? Because he's at 4 mech. I'm curious what's his comp. So, Weatherlight taking the loss here. He'll be dropping.
So Weatherlight finishing at 4.
Yeah.
Fourth place. Fourth place is 4 points, right?
Oh, wait. Let me check. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. 5 points.
5 points?
If I'm correct. So I'm jumping to switch instead of daiske. I cannot spectate them yet, so that's the reason why we're jumping into a lesser health player.
I can't spectate anyone, so we'll probably just go to switch and Oiger.
Switch will be facing a ghost of Weatherlight. So if Switch will definitely win here, I think, because Weatherlight wasn't able to upgrade his board because he lose already. While for Oiger facing Mana Storm, this is my first time seeing Mana Storm. Oh wow! So it's a full mech build with the Baron plus Apprentice.
Baron.
Yeah.
Based on the stats here, it's 55% for George to win, 9% to lethal. So let's see. So meaning he has an advantage. But I'm not sure if the stats counts the Divine Shield. Divine Shield refresh. That's big.
Yeah, sniping the Baron is big. As for Switch, he survives one more turn. So I think Oiger will win this match against daiske. And oh no! Wow. So Oiger will drop and daiske will be the one facing Switch on the showdown, top two showdown.
So Oiger there getting third place with 6 points. Pretty good score, right? So I think finishing in the top 4 in this lobby, sir, really good for your overall chances.
So the game is over for Oiger taking 987, no, 6 points. I cannot jump into Oiger's board, so the left one, I mean daiske board, so we'll only be watching from Switch perspective here. Until the end of...
So, for Switch, actually, I think now getting Nadina is probably...
Is great, yeah. But the problem is that...
Refresh, right?
Yeah, the refresh of the...
Refresh of the mechanic.
Yes. And I'm not sure if daiske hits a new triple, but if he didn't, it's almost the same board as we seen earlier. So it's the same board.
I'm just posting.
I know, not the same board because there's double Meccano Egg now.
That's big. Sniping the Divine Shield on the first Meccano.
Yeah, that's true. So probably Switch will win this. What's the win percentage? Can you see it on your screen?
Actually, I'm spectating it on the other
on your
screen.
Phone. Okay.
So, yep, on the tablet actually. But I think the Switch will win, but I'm not sure if it's actually lethal. So
it would be lethal if either of the Kalekos or Razorgore survives. So it's lethal, right?
Yep. It's lethal.
So
it's
congrats to Switch with his dragon build running the whole tavern.
So Daiske there, but second 8 points, and of course getting the 9 points for round one. And yeah, I'm not sure what turn did Switch got the Kalec Ghost, but I think it's
probably
kinda, early also
turn 8, or maybe it's from his discover, cause Razorgore maybe it's also from discover. So we're on the current standing after round one. Switch taking 9 points, Daiske with 8 points, Oiger with 6 points, Weatherlight with 5 points, Daddy only 3 points, JudeQuinn 2 points, Mapo with 1 point, Grappha with 0. So we'll take a short break, fix some difficulties to smoothen the lag experience by our viewers. And also the giveaway mechanics for the first Tavern Pass. I'll set it up. So guys, just wait and see what will happen on round two. And any other words, Kara?
Good game one. Dragons prevailing here. So exciting to see other builds on the next few rounds. So yeah, see you after 5 minutes.
Sure. Taking a break. Now we're back on our Hearthstone Battlegrounds Prime community tournament for the Philippines with our top 8 MMR players that signed up. How's the round one, Kara?
I think there's a different kinds of builds during the round one, right? So Switch winning with Dragon. The second place, Daiske using Mech.
Yeah, Mech the
and Prata. Oiger with Demons. Weatherlight with
Menagerie.
And Daddy Oni, forgot his build, but JudeQuinn, I think, with Murloc. So he died early. Didn't get to set up some big Murlocs, but yeah, so there's different lot of different compositions that viewers can actually learn and, you know, pick out their strategies. So, pretty good round one.
So,
and, 9 points. Daiske, 8 points.
So, next round, at round 2, will be spectating first JudeQuinn and Daiske, who haven't appeared on our stream yet. And for our giveaway, explain the mechanics, Kara.
Okay, so for the giveaway, we use the, is it hashtag BG Prime, right?
Yeah.
So it's hashtag BG Prime. And yeah, type hashtag BG Prime, but you need to make sure that you're subscribed to Enly's YouTube channel. That's your YouTube, Enly?
Enly PH. Can be seen on my camera. On my camera.
youtube.com/nlph and my youtube.com/CaraCute. I'm giving away also you know, packs there and creating some more Battlegrounds content, so do check it out, youtube.com/CaraCute, and of course Enly's stream. I'll also link it in chat. So make sure, yeah, just hashtag BG Prime, then follow the YouTube. We'll validate later the winner. Validate later. We'll announce it after round 2. First winner announce after round 2, and then the next winner announce after round 4. So, yeah, after the last round.
So, I'm instructing the players to ready themselves now. Again, we'll be featuring JudeQuinn and Daiske for this round.
Exciting to see how Daiske pilots his character. Hopefully, we can see the, you know, the picking.
And the new heroes.
In the first round, we didn't get to see any new heroes. So, hopefully, we can see heroes new heroes on this next round.
Maybe we can instruct our players to rope out their selection, right?
Yeah. I'm also telling so that we can see.
Tell them to rope out their selection.
For sure. We want to also discuss what are the best heroes and discuss with the viewers this the best heroes to pick. What comp is not available, right? So we'll see. Let's see if we can get to see their picking phase. They're queuing up right now, so we'll take them in a few minutes. Mm-hmm. For Grappa here, I think he needs to get at least top 4 for the next 2 rounds.
Yeah, bottom 4 to have a chance for the
top 3. Right?
Maybe he could do it if he could get back-to-back first on 3rd and 4th, but we're not sure. Switch and Daiske should perform underwhelmingly if that's Kappa's game plan to win the last 2 rounds.
So, yeah, just waiting for them to queue. And for the viewers, who are you rooting for these players? Type it in chat. We'll know who has the most fans. Hello, Enly, where's round 2?
They're not yet jumping in.
Okay, let's wait. Start.
So I'm making a poll. Weatherlight, JudeQuinn, Switch, Oiger, Daiske, Daddy Oni.
Oh, I think there's also a few questions in case one they're wondering what is the MMR of these players? I mean, the lowest ceiling. I think that Daddy Oni is the last one with around 7,500.
Yeah, that's correct.
So if you have more than 7,500, didn't submit your what do you call this?
Your forms.
Should have been invited here.
Yeah,
his MMR slide stripe is actually Mapo with around 12k MMR. So yeah.
But don't fret. We have a lot of Battlegrounds party tournaments remaining this month, right? For next week there will be two.
Yep. We'll announce it probably later also, maybe before round 3. Oh yeah, I can see now JudeQuinn selection here. Is Millificent, Mana Storm, Lich, Baziel, and Dino Tamer, Brand, and Patchwork. So the lobby has no Murlocs. No Murlocs. And for Dice, Dice doesn't have any Tavern Pass. He only has Dancing Deryl and the Great Akazam Zarak.
So you should root for Dice. Root for Dice.
Dice. Getting the what do you call this? Dancing Deryl here and JudeQuinn surprisingly going with the mecha. Because there's no Murlocs, I think that's why he didn't pick the Dino Tamer brand. So he chose to go for the mech. And daiske here with a good start with tokens. So that's good for him because Deryl's very good with the token builds. So, and for JudeQuinn here, choosing to hold on the Swabby, probably thinking that Maiev will not play or maybe use hero power, so it's going to be a tie. So, doesn't want to waste the free there. So, as you can see, JudeQuinn ending with a tie. Not playing the Swabby, so that is going to have an early. He will have a discount for the Tavern up later on. And daiske, they're losing to what do you call this? Rafaam with the dragons with the puppy.
So again, Mapo is on Maiev. If you didn't notice, another chance for him to play Maiev. Grappha now on Noz.
And switch again with Rafaam. Still very good minion. Top tier minion. Daddy Oni using the new hero, Jandis Barov, with X in the pool. So probably we can see X who goes later. Oiger going with the Elise Starseeker. And now, daiske here will sell the Alicat and probably buy this to the dragon and the boat buff from the Alicat, the Tabby Cat. And JudeQuinn buying two minions pair the Necro Machine. So JudeQuinn facing Jandis Barov here. Let's see what Jandis Barov has. Okay, he has demons so far.
So Kara, kindly remove your cam. Sorry for interruption. There you go. Now we're back into the action. I already fixed the overlay. Everything is neat.
Let's see here. For daiske here, for sure is going to buy the free dealing gambler, but still, all of these minions are actually good. Four minions are really good.
He won't dance now. So just buy. And
just
buy the T3.
And buy the gambler for sure. And this is actually a very strong board already for
for Deryl or daiske.
Yep.
As for JudeQuinn, he already buffed his scaling micro machine, and he also have a pre-dealing gambler.
So, I think for Deryl easily winning that fight versus Mapo. And next turn is probably going to just Tavern and look for a good tier 3 minion next turn to dance on. So here is actually pretty interesting if he's going to buy the token for more dances.
Yeah, I think he'll go for the token and for the more dances and maybe a chance for triple. But
also, yeah, I think so too.
Although Deryl doesn't need a triple, right? In the early game, he needs only dances.
Yep. So he went for the biggest, I mean the best minion there, which is the Harvest Golem. And for JudeQuinn choosing to freeze the 4-2.
Yes.
So that he can refresh. Yeah, then refresh the 4-3. I mean refresh the deflecto bot here.
What's nice here is he got the deflecto bot out of the upgrade plus selling the gambler. So that's nice pick up for JudeQuinn.
Oh wait, so meaning JudeQuinn early Tavern, he doesn't have any triples, right?
Yeah,
he early level.
Yeah, really. He level he sell his gambler.
Oh, okay. Sorry, I didn't see it. So here, Deryl losing to Rafaam, taking 8 damage. That's big. At next turn, I think he just needs to dance on this best minion. But there's none. Do you think of dancing with the Macau? Is it good or no?
I think it's bad.
Here, another roll gets Macau and 3 tier 1 minions. So I think it's still roll.
I think this is dance. He could dance now.
Okay, so he's freezing the board.
Maybe he'll go for the Yoho Ogre dance later.
So he's going to buy one more minion here, right? So either just thinking what to buy, but still going to sell it later on.
So probably he'll buy the 1-1, Kindly Grandmother. As for JudeQuinn, he got a free dealing gambler. His Hungry Dragon didn't buffed up because he lost earlier. And he's facing Daddy Oni with Jandis Barov. Demon comp right now at Tavern 2. So there's a Pogo, Kara, on Jandis. Hello, Kara? Are you speaking?
Me? Hello?
Hello, I can hear you now.
Okay. There's a Pogo. How many Pogos?
Only one.
Okay. That's good enough, right? Because you can just start swapping the Pogos.
Yes.
And Jandis is at Tavern 2. So if he sees more Pogos, he probably just stay. I think Pogo is the best build for Jandis. So.
Yeah, but it tee up. He tavern up.
Right tavern now. Up? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, that's weird. So, probably not going Pogos. By the way, just to recap, so for those doesn't have any Tavern pass in this tournament, so there's actually 2 players. So that's Oiger and daiske. So both players doesn't have Tavern pass, so they're kind of handicapped, only choosing 2 minions. But
2 heroes.
But the rest of the field has Tavern passes, so... Again, daiske finishing 2nd place.
If my intel is correct, you mentioned that Weatherlight just bought a Tavern Pass with gold, right? Or no?
Did he... That's actually for his other account.
Ah, okay. So
but this one, I think he has the gold for sure and the rest of the resources that he needs. So Okay, dice choosing to freeze this board. Why do you think Enly dice freeze this board?
It's kind of hard to think, but there's a demon buffer, so maybe that's one of the reason he'll what you call it, eye for a demon comp. Although Deryl doesn't rely on comp that much, but that's one of the reason why I think he froze that board. Hello, Kara, are you speaking?
No, I'm not.
Okay.
I think dice closing again to. For my feedback with Mapo, I think Deryl is not good with the greedier. I mean the aggressive board states. But the other option from Daisk earlier is not good as well. Forgot what's the other option for Daisk?
Do
you remember?
No, I didn't.
The secret guy.
Oh. Akazam Zarak.
Akam Zarak. So okay, so Dice choosing to dance to the imprisoner. So
oh. So it's kinda weird. Yeah, he could have solved the sequencing error for Dice there. He'll be facing JudeQuinn. So oh. Now JudeQuinn has a chance to triple his metal tooth leaper next turn. But for now he'll be staying with this board. I'm not sure if this is strong enough. Probably strong enough if the hits are good. Since he's already have a defect of what?
So let's see here. Oh, will win this battle. I think earlier we didn't get we saw Weatherlight and Mapo fight, right? But just in the maybe early round one.
Yeah.
This one we are on turn 8, so it's quite crucial because Deryl's also at 18 life. So that one is a good trade for him. That value trading with a micro machine. Looks like he's going to win this.
So with Dice 18 health now, it's kind of hard for him to tavern up to 5. So maybe he'll be staying at 4 the most of the later game, right?
For sure. But one thing I noticed also, Dice, not sure if he chose the demon, but he's going again for the demon comp. Not sure if it is favorite build. Because earlier... He went with demon also, right?
It's oiger.
Oh, okay.
Always both with the JudeQuinn, right? Both or gas coiler, but he's a mech build, so for reaper.
Reaper.
I'm not sure, but if you're a streamer, it will always be both. Someone 3 random pirates.
Let's see, just a quick review of the standing. So Weatherlight at first with Mix. Jandis, Mixed Minion, so I don't know. Apo with Demons. Of course, Ives really good with Demons comp. And JudeQuinn, now we're spectating at fourth place with Mix, for sure. Switch with Beast, but already on Tavern 6. Wow. And Dice, Demons, Tavern 4. Grappa, Pirates 2 with Tavern 5 and Oiger, East 5, Tavern 4.
And
so,
to add additional information, Mapo hit already 2 goldens na 2 triples now. So compared to round 1 that he had a hard time getting triples, he got a 2. Also switch with his Rafaam.
Yeah, and Elise, who is also at 9, I mean just at 9 life right now, also hit 2 triples, so probably not hitting the triples he needed for his comp. So why is on the last place.
So we can now see Switchboard. He got a Gascoiler along with Mama Bear. So probably he'll pivot to full beast. Yeah, with 5 beast now.
And the Infested Wolf, value trading with a 3-3, it's good for him. But hindi, I think Esk needs to kill the Mama Bear there. Can still tie. Oh no, lost. But with that, actually, has 10% chance to win for the Deryl and 85% to lose. So that's the expected outcome.
No scam happened there.
Yeah. But it actually has 27.5% lethal, so didn't die.
When you play mech build, do you sell the golden metal to Tleeper to include it again on the pool, or you'll just sit it there?
It depends on the stats, but for example, this one is 11.9. But if you can buff it with a Anoyo module, of course you keep it, but it depends on the Metal Tooth Leaper stats.
Okay.
Actually, did the one video for the mech magnetize.
Yeah, that's.
I got the golden Metal Tooth Leaper, but
I
buffed.
I think it's 33 attack. Yeah, I comment there that I saw. It's the first time I see a big Metal Tooth Leaper.
It depends on the stats. If you buff it earlier, like. You don't have anything to buff with the 3-1. What's the 3-1? Microbots.
Forget the name.
Microbots.
Yeah.
Okay, so here, Dice finally finding a good minion to dance with, which is the Beast, the Hydra. But I'm not sure if it's too late for
yeah,
him.
Yeah, kind of late. And JudeQuinn is facing Jandis Barov with 2 Pogwas.
No. Daiske is facing Yog.
I mean JudeQuinn facing Tadeoni with 2 Pogos.
So
I think he left the Tavern 2 just to rush for the Anoyo module.
Okay. But is Pogo still not triple, right?
So yeah, it's not triple. And he loses. I mean, that only loses to JudeQuinn, the mech
and
queen.
Dice is out. Dice also is out. Died.
From first to last.
Yep. So that's 0 points for him. It's really hard to play Deryl, actually.
So who are we going to jump into? Maybe that only since he's playing a.
Yeah, let's go for Daddy Oni.
Is playing a Pogo, Jandis. I think the stream got better without the camera moving on the stream. So it's better viewership for our dear other players.
Okay, so we'll be seeing the Pogo Jandis for all the Pogo lovers.
And he got a brand, by the way.
Wow! Is that from the Discover?
Yeah, right? It's from Discover, right? Discover of Triple Selfless Hero. So I think it's kind of strong now. Who will be his first big team? Weatherlight. With mechs.
Will you choose to buy the Gold Grabber? Not sure about the Gold Grabber because maybe, I'm actually
maybe because there's a slot, so the 2 goldens would be staple in his comp. So the moving pieces will be Cobalt Scalebane, the Cobalt Scalebane if he needs to upgrade something. I think Weatherlight's board won't be enough for this. That the only is Pogos, but it's kind of good, right? With double refreshers, with double double deflectobot, double eggs, and a baron. Same with daiske earlier.
Yep.
So another casualty. Oiger going down versus JudeQuinn. And actually that's two. Even switch. So our top three earlier is now bottom three. So it's like the equilibrium, we're on a state of equilibrium again because they won't get the lump sum of the scores, right? So there will be a lot of tie after this round.
So now we'll see the Pogo now with the brand. It's pretty interesting. So what did he sell? No, he didn't sell anything. He just switched the Pogo and have some extra slot. So he can yeah, he's going for the jug.
Then
didn't hit the Pogo.
Yeah. And he'll be facing a ghost of switch. So this is gonna be easy easy turn for him.
So switch there getting 2 points, so yes, total of
11.
No.
Or 11 or 10?
11. Yep.
Okay. So he that the only freeze for an IO module. Now JudeQuinn's. Will you triple a deflectobot here? If you're JudeQuinn's. The other deflectobot is kinda small.
I think yes, because I want to add more. Want to add another minion.
Okay.
And the mech, the what do you call this?
The Clangers or the Foe Reaper can be discovered from that golden also, right?
Yeah, and the problem is so the mech is attacking first, right? The cleave, and then you have the second mechano, so attacking. So you also want the other mechano to attack first, but it can be sniped early if it didn't attack earlier. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So you need to just have at least two. Okay. So I think Mapo
going down.
Here.
So we are
Weatherlight losing to Noz. Grappha. Wait, Weatherlight is actually first earlier and now fourth.
Yeah. So now JudeQuinn is the one facing a ghost. Ghost of Weatherlight.
So Mapo here getting, I'm just updating the scores. Mapo here getting 4 points and Weatherlight getting five points for finishing fourth. Still top four finish for Weatherlight.
So these are bad options for JudeQuinn's triple. Only Zap. And Zap would be effective, maybe. No, not. The Zap is not effective at all because there's no Baron build remaining, I think, because probably this Grappha is playing a full dragon build later.
You also noticed, even if JudeQuinn is facing the ghost, didn't
the up,
you know, level.
Yeah.
Yes, because probably knows that Weatherlight is also
kinda strong.
Weatherlight's board is kind of strong, so doesn't want to die. So instead of going levels, just improve his board.
So this could be a good use of Baron, but he cleaved it out, so that's fine.
So now we can see, it's the first time actually I saw the Noz is actually
and
going
double Kalekos with the Dina, so that's super strong. But maybe not enough for this round against this double Pogo, right?
Yep. So Grappha finishing third place. So that's good from zero earlier, right?
Yeah.
And now finishing third place with 6 points. And yeah, we're down to the last two guys that
we're spectating. Yeah, it's showdown again. It's nice that we spectate JudeQuinn from the start. We saw his progress. It will be Pogots versus full mechs, almost full mech. It will depend on this Gascoiler summoning as needs, then a summoning a Maiev na. Because he needs a Poisonous to kill this big 115, 117 Pogo, right?
Yep. So it looks like this is a win for the Jandis Pogo. One thing to note also, I think when Daddy Oni leveled up, he doesn't have any plans on tripling the Pogo.
Yeah.
Because if you triple it, you can't switch it, right? So maybe you just went to go ahead and start leveling up and look for the Annoyo modules.
And he got lucky to get a Brand out from that one of his triples. Because that sped up the scaling of Pogo.
So, interesting, JudeQuinn playing the Zap. I think it's just because there's none and any more good minions instead yes. of, you know,
that's a better
using it for like Baron.
Mm-hmm. Better stat than yep. the Harvest Golem.
But as we can see, it will only kill the Bran and yeah, nothing else. Ah, no, it didn't even hit it. Looks like the Pogo, the 198 Pogo is still very strong to, you know...
To deal with, yeah. Without poisonous. Let's see. Oh no, if the Gascoiler was traded first and get the scam the Trattles. Yo, This is not enough.
But it's not yet lethal. It's actually 0.4% to lethal. Although the win percentage is 96.8, but just 4 plus 4 more.
So
probably two more turns.
Yeah, but JudeQuinn needs to take in a Poisonous now. As you can see, he cannot beat the Pogo. The first Pogo, by the way. Taunted Pogo.
Oh, he leveled up to 6, yeah.
Will he be able to get that?
He needs to look for the Poisonous.
Or survive one more turn to look for the Poisonous.
Oh, got a triple. Triple, but doesn't have the gold. Oh,
I think he'll go for that. Oh, wow. A Gascoiler may or the Shredder may be sold.
Yeah, okay. So he will sell the Shred.
But it's not good because he'll be a 6 units player if that's to happen. So he'll be trying to survive one more turn and see if he could get a Poisonous.
So what's happening? Pog.
So now, Daddy Oni having 4 Divine Shields. Possible 4 Divine Shields. But it would be devastating if the other Divine Shields go for Selfless Heroes.
Selfless Hero.
Yeah.
As what we've mentioned, Daddy Oni is actually the lowest MMR player here. But as you can see, MMR is just a number.
Yeah. If you know how to pilot the composition and heroes well, you could succeed here. Most of the time, the MMR corresponds to how you place well, how you tech well on other players, right? But for the building of your composition, it's natural. You could adapt very well.
And I think they actually already announced it, one of the developers, right? That the MMR will be reset. So in the coming patches. So
we can see one more turn for JudeQuinn here.
Yep. Because this is just 8 damage. Yep. So probably the last round. The last round for this match. I think Jandis can level. I don't know what else to improve. Maybe get one more selfless hero for triple.
Yeah, that's one of his.
Okay, he got it.
Then so got maybe the... get a Baron.
Let's see.
Too bad. My Exna is not showing up on the tavern. Is this a Maexna from Gascoiler? Nope. Gascoiler, go.
So this is a triple Gascoiler, right? For JudeQuinn?
Yeah.
That's four random death rattle minions.
So JudeQuinn's going for a most possible scam here with 2 Gascoiler, 1 needs.
And Jandis freezing, of course, the Anoyo module for next turn for more divine shields.
Too bad. Maxna is really important here because it would be super close if the first big Pogo got killed.
One thing to note also that Murlocs is not here, right? So yeah, the Pogo are really unstoppable. If there's no Murlocs, so there's no Poisonous.
Only Poisonous is Mike's na. So, kinda hard to get since it's a Tavern 6 minion.
So, after this game, we're going to announce our first winner, Enli.
Okay.
Let's announce our first winner.
There you go! 1 Mike's na coming down, but didn't snipe out the Pogo Hopper. Too bad.
What can he get from the Death Rattle minions?
Sneeds again.
To my ex na?
Yeah.
No. Okay.
So I think it's official. It would be Daddy Onis taking the round 2 lobby.
At 9 points. And JudeQuinn, also a good showing here. Tried his best. Couldn't stop the Pogos. So, yeah.
Roll for 2 rounds for Poisonous, but no my ex na. Kara, you can turn on your camera now.
Or wait. Did you guys enjoy that round 2? What can you say?
The round 2 was super fun.
Jandis. Ban Jandis in the lobby. How about a nerf incoming? Do you predict any nerfs? For the Jandis. I think for me personally, no nerf yet because still fun to play.
Yeah, that's true. And so, it only works well with mechs in and Murlocs out, right? That's the best outcome for Pogo Jandis.
Yep.
So
noticed that I'm watching the delay stream, but I just noticed both of them hitting the triples on that last turn. So, Daddy Oni hitting the triple selfless and then JudeQuinn hitting the triple Gascoiler also. So, pretty fair match. I wanted to see the triples. How many they got? I think JudeQuinn has maybe 4 or 5 and Jandis maybe 3 or 4. So yeah. Should we announce and just announce the winner before we go on break?
Wait, where's your camera? Where's your camera?
It's on.
No, it's not on.
it's on for me.
I video disabled by you. Oh no.
Oh no. Hold on. It's on.
Yeah, okay. So I can see you now. So wait. Before we take the break, the winner would be this is just for who are you rooting for. I won't be announcing this. This is for the whole lobby. I mean whole tournament. So Mapo is leading with 71%, Dandy only with 28%. I'm not sure if because Jandis was being played by Daddy Oni earlier, but now this is the giveaway.
The winner is
closed. Announced that the giveaway is closed. Draw entrant.
Make sure the winner doesn't have any battleground. I mean tavern pass because it's just going to be put in the account. So
David Nation X.
David Nation X, congrats for winning the tavern pass.
Chat if you have the tavern pass already, because if you haven't, if you have it, we'll just roll it. Wait, let's ask him.
Sure. Tavern pass. Actually, yeah, I agree. That is too good, especially without Murlax. As per Ren's HS. So the first winner, David Nation X, alam ko subscriber na yan eh. So confirmed. We just need to confirm if he has tavern pass. But we need your
I don't have it. So okay. So
congratulations, David
let's
Nation
accept.
X. We will need your battle tag. Hi Dre next. We'll need your battle tag and your email address for that. Andy will just message you.
So with that, we're going to take a short break again. And
wait, we'll discuss the scores anyway.
Okay. So I thought we were ready.
The current standing here, it's actually Daddy Oni now with 12 points. Finishing that lobby in that first place, and I think the first one he got 3 points from the first round. Then second place, Switch with 11 points. Next one, Weatherlight with 10, tied with JudeQuinn with 10, daiske with 9. Although yeah, finishing runner up right in the second, and then
yes,
last place on that, so 9. Oiger with 7 points, Grappha with 6, and Mapo struggling with 5 points. So yeah, those guys voting for Mapo, 71%. Can still win this actually with couple of top 4 finish. So we'll resume with round 3. We'll announce more tournament. So for those that are watching, we're going to announce the next tournament later on. So stay tuned after the break.
Our tournament, Hearthstone Battlegrounds Prime. 2 rounds already been finished with Daddy Onis on the lead. Just to remind you, we'll be having 2 more tournaments. Next week, we'll have 2 tournaments of Battlegrounds. So, what's the first,
one? The first one is the Battlegrounds Knockout by Excelsior. Actually, he already did a teaser, but it's this coming Friday. So you can sign up already. Enly will put the sign up sheet in chat. So the knockout is actually 1v1. It's open to all players across Southeast Asia. So you can join, and anyone can join. It's 1v1. It's of course using the lobby. The rules are already there in Mogul, and we'll be giving away almost the same prizes. So it's $100 Blizzard balance, and then also giving away tavern passes for the participants. So random participants, two random participants gets tavern passes. So if you didn't win today with a giveaway of Enli, then you can just join the Battlegrounds knockout and try your chances there for tavern passes. And there's another one.
So the next one for me would be on Sunday. Next Sunday, not tomorrow. BG Duos. I already said it on the command. You could sign up now. And you have to look for a partner to register. So look for a partner now in our community. We'll only be accepting 16 pairs, so that's 32 players. And For this tournament, we'll not be advising to use Discord because there's a lot of people, not voice comms, because there's a lot of people playing on mobile. So just use chat to play fair, right, Kara?
Yep. So no need for Discord, and of course to remove the disadvantages for those using mobile. So you can just use chat. If you want to use emotes, it's okay also. So like what we've said, find a partner now for the duos. It's next Sunday. So yeah, look for your partner already. If you don't have a partner, go to the Hearthstone Philippines page. Look for a partner there. Maybe post looking for.
Or maybe when I officially announce the tournament on the page, use it as recruitment, right?
Yeah, you can ask there, or maybe you can go to the Discord, AKG Discord or Enlist Discord, look for a partner there. No restrictions for MMR, so it's okay. Any MMR. So yeah, going to round 3, let's just recap of the score. So these are the scores, last 2 rounds. Basically, this Mapo can still, of course, at the top 3, but for now the top 3 players are Daddy Oni, Switch and Weatherlight. So again, the top 3 players will get Blizzard balance, $100 worth of Blizzard balance. So
and we'll
go ahead.
I already told Mapo to ready, and we'll be spectating Switch and Oiger this time.
Okay, so round 3 is almost here. What builds do you want to see, Enli?
We haven't seen guys, a successful Murloc build, right? We haven't seen Murloc.
Yeah.
I want to see a Lord Barov that wins.
If we have Lord Barov, we should expect the Lord Barov.
Okay, sure.
So if we get a Lord Barov, we're just going to switch because it's fun watching
how to waging use the hero power.
We want to watch the waging. So for now, we're going to spec Switch and
Oiger.
Oiger. But if we see a Lord Barov, we're just going to switch to the Lord Barov. But I think Enli, they will not pick Lord Barov because this is a tournament, so they want to win. They don't want to gamble, right? They don't want to wager. So if I'm a player, I don't want to wager my chances of winning. So let's see if someone will pick Lord Barov here. I also want to see Omo as well. I want to see the new hero here. So we already see Jandis, so I want to see Omo. And the last tavern pass will be giving away after round 4.
So we're now jumping to Switch and Oiger. Again, Oiger doesn't have what do you call it? Tavern pass.
Yep.
Oh no. There you go. We can see Switch having an Oiger Lord Barov on his selection.
Is he going to pick
it? I don't know.
We need to tell Switch Lord Barov. So for Oiger here, he has Nosdormu and Lich King, both good minions. So I think either is fine for me, maybe Lich King.
What's missing on the lobby? So, oiger is Lich King. No.
There's no demons.
No demons. Okay.
There's no demons. So for oiger here for sure, Righteous Protector is a good one to use the reborn. But Dragon Spawn is also very good, 2-3 stats. But I think you still go with the protector. Basically, it's 4-4. Yeah, in theory, it's 4-4. And switch here again with the Rafaam. So earlier, it didn't finish like around third to the last, maybe sixth place. So now he's back to Rafaam. He didn't pick the Lord Barov. That would be fun.
Would switch, be fun why? To watch.
No fun switch. Saying Mapo, VG duos with Mapo brothers connection. Wow, switch with another, with possible triple on the next turn with another tide caller. So let's see how switch does it. Maybe sells the 2-1 and triples the tokens. So he has another chance for another triple. So, and for oiger here, yeah, just leveling on 4. Oh, it's a switch versus oiger. So I think this is a tie, right? Yep. And switch getting the righteous protector. Let's see the other heroes in the lobby. So Edwin Van Cleef, Grappha using Edwin Van Cleef. Weatherlight using Mana Storm. Daddy Oni with the Curator. JudeQuinn with Maiev. Actually, this is the third Maiev in the lobby. So, first two is Mapo Maiev, and then the third one is JudeQuinn Maiev. Then Mapo now in the Elite Star Seeker. And Daiske with the Shudderwalk. So, for oiger, choosing to buy the Enzoth. And the Reborn is very good with that Rattle Minion. I didn't see what Switch did, but I think he freeze again to do the triple next turn. He got a Murloc War Leader, so it's very good for his Murlocs.
Yay, I'm done.
Wow. Can you see this, Rafaam?
Yes, I told you there's no successful Murloc build earlier. Maybe this is the time to see a Murloc build. And that's a potential double triple because of the token, right?
Yep. It's potential double. It's guaranteed actually na triple because of that. So I'm not sure. I think Switch will grid it. Oh no. Okay. Oh, he's going to triple this turn. Maybe that's what I'm going to say. Maybe he'll just level up next turn and do the triple. With the Swabby, he can do it. So triple and
as for Lich King Oiger, he got a Nazoth there, right? So he got a good minion start. So now he just need to survive until maybe the mid to late game, because Nazoth is really important for Lich King because of his reborn.
One more thing here, Switch got another Murloc, which is the old Merc Eye. So looks like Switch is going to have a very good game for this round.
Hopefully,
it depends also
hopefully
on
that's,
the discover.
Yeah, hopefully this is not a bait.
Okay, so he has 2 mechs and 1 dragon. What do you like here, Andy?
I think I could pick Dragonid Enforcer here. Oh, we go for egg.
I think, yeah, because Egg is the best statted minion.
The only reason why I want the Draconid was there's one Divine Shield already present, but maybe that's not that good compared to the Egg.
The reasoning there is probably Switch will just sell it next turn, so there will be no synergy with the dragon. So we just went for the Egg. Because if he's going for the Murloc build, he's going to be weak on the first few rounds. So having the Egg here will help him, like, you know, give him more stats.
So, it would have been better if he could have got the Outlook there, right? And get a Primal Fin or Cold Lights here. But that's a perfect roll of RNG. So first loss for Switch. As for our Lich King, he's struggling to hold his HP. But he got a good... mech start. Now he has a Deflect Robot and Harvest Golem.
Interesting why we add it in the what do you call this? In the Deflecto instead of the Harvest Golem. What do you think about
Maybe because the Harvest Golem is temporary minion for him and he could sell it later. But it also have the refresh capability with just his own Death Rattle. So for the Deflecto bot, he'll have another three after it dies, right?
Yeah, most, I think, yes. But here, the Macau has a lot of target, so it can be the micro.
So it's hard. And it'll be facing Switch.
Oh, yeah, they'll be facing each other.
So Switch getting a Macau, and that's good for him. He could throw out his beast then play Macau just for the eggs.
Oh, I think Lich King will win here, right?
Yeah, Lich King will win. Absolutely.
But yeah.
And the Deflector Bot was pop out, but it's the same. It's fine.
But the other tokens could have, you know,
same value, almost the same value. I'm not sure how many HP left for Switch minion before he hit the Deflector Bot, but I think it's almost the same.
So for Switch, is still deciding if it's Murlocs or Najiri. Because right now, it's not getting any Murlocs.
Yeah. So that's, I think it's fine with this build currently. With a lot of Goldens, he'll play Buffer and with Macau.
Yeah, the gold rubber will actually get +6/+6,
yes,
right? Per turn, so
wow, oh, another gold grabber.
Is yep.
So maybe Switch will abandon the Murloc comp depending on his next rolls. He'll just use the three golden Murlocs to pump out the gold grabber.
One thing to notice also, Milhouse is now at Tavern 5 and he got what do you call this? Nightfang already in board. So he's probably going for the Menagerie build.
Yeah, T5 at 40 health with 5 win streak. So, oops. Jinxed.
Jude, Daiske is now what, 6 life? Wow. So as we said earlier, using Murlocs is you're very weak in the early turns. So you can see the Tavern tier 3 only 6 life. So kind of rough game for him after finishing last place also on round 2. So let's see if he's going to survive this round.
And as we can see on switchboard, he abandoned the war leader. So the use of the 3 Murlocs here is to buff out the 2 gold grabbers. And look for better right. composition next turn since he's already at T5.
So he's just thinking if he should sell the 2-2 and then the glyph or wait next turn.
I think he'll just wait. He'll sit here because the +6/+6, actually +12/+12 this turn is crucial for him. He's looking for a poisonous so he could keep his Murlocs, some of his Murlocs.
Let's see what he will get. I didn't die. Still not.
So reviewing the lobby, Weatherlight Mana Storm is running that. You could see the comp on the left side of the screen. Switch on a split pirate Murloc with golden card, of course. JudeQuinn with mixed minions. Menagerie, you could see on right side with oigers fighting him.
Lich one thing to notice also, Switch got the Light Fang. So Daiske is out. Another 8 place finish.
Yeah, with 0 Murloc. Points.
0 points for him.
And Rafaam is going down with 13 health. So he Switch needs to fight weaker opponents. So now it's 3-8. So he'll sell the 3-8 now. The egg now.
Do you think? Because he also has the Light Fang.
What do you want to sell?
I think I'll sell the 2-2.
2-2? It's kind of hard to evaluate because you have a scaling gold grabber.
Mm. Okay, so Toxfin for sure.
Yeah, Toxfin. So we can see that the 2-2 will survive now. It won't get abandoned.
Okay, so...
Oh, wow. Another Primal Fin lookout for Switch. This is showdown. And he'll be facing Lich King. Probably, even Switch lose here, he can survive because I think his board is kind of strong. Wow, Cold Lights here.
Please. Okay, so yeah. With that brand pickup, Switch decided to just go for Murlocs.
Yes.
And then looking for the triple on the Gold Grabber. So,
it will space up.
Hard for it.
Yeah, he needs to space, additional space for new minion.
Maknavi, Miskara, pwede ka pa maging dugo? I'm not sure if I think I'm not allowed to play, so I won't be able to participate.
So, Switch winning the showdown, stream showdown.
Yep. That's 10 damage.
Both at 13 health. It's super important that he hit a poisonous from the outlook and the King Burgurgle. But of course, Bran made that turn super beneficial for Switch. For Oiger now, he's looking for triples. And he's still at Menagerie build without Light Fang. So Switch, despite not playing the Menagerie build now, He has a light pang 100.
I think he will buy the defender here.
I think it's good. To buff up two of his minions.
Yep. And the brand is always the correct.
And he'll get the Bloodsail Cannoneer also. Oh wow, no. So it's not important to buff up the gold grabber. So King Bagurgle for freeze.
I think I can still sell it. Depends if there's time, but maybe no. No time more. No time. So the Macau in hand of Switch has this possibility to be triple. So it's good to keep it. And Maiev na with Amalga dun. Probably discovering it from the tier 6.
Triple. Four yep. Triples. This is the best Maiev so far. Because I think Mapo only hit 2 or 3 earlier before he lost the lobby.
Yeah, and I think Lich King will win this versus Pelaus.
Yes. Snipe that 2-1, wow. So, least number of damage he could take that turn, that sequence. So now, Switch is rolling.
And Curator is out, that's the Oni.
Oh.
Is out at 7th place.
Only 1 point for Daddy Oni now. So
that means that we'll probably have a new
top standings, scorer. Yeah.
Top scorer after this.
Switch is running for the first place now with this kind of comp. 2 poisonous already and scaling gold grabber.
Yeah. Who do you think will? I'm just asking the viewers who they think will win. I think Switch has a good chance.
Yeah.
Although his life is very low at 13 health, still the board is pretty strong.
I wasn't able to take a look on Weatherlight's board earlier, even though he fought Lich King.
Weatherlight has
I saw a brand.
I think it's Mex, right?
So he's a menagerie because he still have a light pang, I guess, because he got it early, right?
Yes. I got it early. So Lich King fighting Pantleaf here.
Wow, that's a good
78% chance to win and 27% lethal.
That's a good
and deal. Van Cleef sniping the Macau is good, but it has a reborn, so let's see.
So Switch taking down Weatherlights for 11 health. So 14 health for Weatherlight now. And 2 more casualties this round. JudeQuinn taking 5th. And Grappha taking 6th.
I actually didn't notice that the Lich King egg is actually already golden.
Yeah.
So I think he needs to buff it now with Screw Junk and the Metal Tooth Leaper.
So I think this is another stream showdown. I mean, Switch versus Oiger. And Switch is currently much stronger than the Lich King. Wow.
Wow. Bagurgel.
And Cold Lights here. I'm not sure if... but it's fine. Because since the Murloc Tidehunter is still not... poisoned. Because Cold Lights here is almost acting, King Bagurgle is acting like the same with the King Bagurgle since the 2 Murlocs are poisonous. But the damage, have difference. And the Detrattle. Oh, that's one of the reason why King Bogrel is much better.
Did the unstable ghoul did Switch bought buy
yeah,
it or
he bought it?
Okay, I thought it got it from the free from the hero power. So now, yeah, Switch versus Lich King. Let's see. I think Switch has way more
for,
stats.
Yeah,
it's probably lethal.
Yeah, lethal. We even with two gold grabbers staying on board.
Okay.
Four
so
plus.
Who are going,
I think this is exact. Need... This exact. I know. Okay.
No, oh, it's over 15. Let's switch.
So this is showdown between Mapo.
Mapo. Wow. And Switch.
Mapo is running pretty high now in this lobby.
So nakabawi si Mapo for this round. So Oiger finishing at fourth, so that's 5 points for him.
So this is the first time I see Mapo's board clearly. He got a golden Baron River. Baron Riven there. But will that be enough to beat this scaling comp of Switch? Is it the time to dump the Brand Bronze Beard Kara?
What do you mean tank? I mean to sell it?
Yeah, to dump. To sell it.
Maybe not yet.
But
there's a very good minion that he can replace it. If there's a really good minion. Oh, he can play the Selfless also last.
Because this is the last turn probably. Because 6 health and 13 health. So Mapo is freezing for next game. So Switch didn't even hit the hero power, right?
I didn't.
So I think he accepted that this is the last game. I mean, yeah, the last turn for this round 3.
I want to see Switch winning streak. It's actually 4. But I think the other Winning streak counts ties or
no? No, it destroys the streak.
You sure?
Yeah, it destroys streak.
I think no.
We'll see next turn. next round. So one more round after this.
Is Mapo going to win?
I mean, round 4. Fourth.
Okay.
Fourth
but
lobby.
For this one, yeah, I think Switch.
Yeah, Switch win this.
So Switch now winning 2 lobbies.
And he's on the lead, probably. On your camera now, Kara. Because we'll be going to the...
On na.
Okay.
So, yes, Switch winning another lobby. If I'm not mistaken, I think Switch hasn't played or practiced Battlegrounds. Because I just see him playing Dota. So, there's a really good chance for Switch to finish,
at
first here.
Yeah, finish top 3.
I'm just updating the score. So Mapo finishing with 8 points. And Weatherlight with 6 points. Hold on. We'll show you the scores in a bit. Yeah. I think it's updated now, Enli. Maybe you can show the scores already.
I'm already showing it while you're updating it.
What's the leaderboard? Leaderboard, Switch at 20 points. And Weatherlight at 16. JudeQuinn, 15 points. Daddy Oni falling from first to fourth place, 13 points. And Mapo, so 5 plus the 9 points is actually, is that correct? Save siya earlier, plus 9.
It's 14
dapat, di ba?
Yeah. 5 plus 9 is 14.
Okay. No, sorry, it's just 8 points.
Okay, cause which one? Okay.
So, yeah. So, that's correct. So, Mapo with 13. So, basically, in order for Mapo to win, we'll just do some analysis. In order for Mapo to win, he needs at least...
He needs first. And switch...
Yeah, maybe first or second to go to the top 3.
Yeah.
Right? So, yeah. So first or second for top 3...
So for Grappa, he can only have a chance for top 2. I mean second or third, but he needs 13 points there. I mean 9 points there first.
Yep. So yeah, the top 3 players will get to win Blizzard Balance. Of course, they can use it whatever games or packs. So, yes, we'll be back for round 4 after the break. It will be the last round, so we'll see who will win the first Battlegrounds Prime. So, see you.
Hello again, we're back now for our final round of Hearthstone Battlegrounds Prime. This is round 4. And we're running another giveaway / raffle on the chat. Just type # Prime again. So
giveaway is 1 tavern pass.
Yeah.
Weatherlight, 8 participants plus 2 casters among us.
That's what I read when I stopped the giveaway note.
So, yeah, the giveaway is 1 tavern pass. So, if you don't have a tavern pass, please join. But if you have, please don't join. Because I think we will inject the tavern pass in your account. So, you need... If you want to join the tavern pass giveaway... What's the keyword? It's # Prime again. So that's # Prime again.
Oh no. Kara.
I joined.
Kara joined.
Oh no.
It's fine.
Again, join the tavern pass. It's # Prime again. For those just joining in the stream. Also later, probably we're just going to announce it again for those who haven't joined yet. The first one only, how many participants for the first?
I think it's 17. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
So before we start again, Kara, let's advertise the tournament for next week.
Yeah. For the tournament next week, again, it's Battlegrounds Knockout hosted by Excelsior and Channel 8. It's open for all Southeast Asian regions, so Vietnam, Philippines, Malaysia, Singapore, Indonesia, Thailand. You can join the tournament. So, for more info, Enli, please type the info. Yeah, BGKO.
Or check Excelsior BGKO, page.
And then for Sunday's event is actually it's a duo. So it's only open for Philippines. So you need to find a partner. So again, if you don't have a partner, look for in the chat or in the Discord channel or in the group, in the partner, no MMR restriction. So yeah, it's exciting. You can be with a friend. So there will be 2 in the lobby, right, Enli, for the duos?
Yeah, yes.
So you will be partner up. Same as the team challenge, the Battlegrounds team challenge. So yeah. Those 2 tournaments, again, we're just going to recap the scores again. So, the first one is Switch with 20 points. If I'm not mistaken, Switch needs at least top 5 for a guaranteed top 3 finish. Weatherlight at 2nd place with 16 points. So for Weatherlight, go ahead and
Weatherlight is even without the explosive finish like top 2, he got a consistent score, consistent showing with his 16 points right now after 3 rounds. Next is JudeQuinn.
I think it's 2 top 4 and 1 top 5, right? Yeah. So yeah, consistency is the key. Then JudeQuinn, 15 points.
Yes. And the next one is Daddy Oni and Mapo. Both are 13 points. And I think Daddy Oni is has the advantage here if they get to the tie. But they won't get to the tie because there's no tie on round 4. And the bottom 3 are Oiger with 12 points, Daiske with 9 points, and Grappha with 8 points. So as for Daiske and Grappha, it looks like they won't be able to get number 1, but there's a miracle run that can include them on top 3, right, Kara?
Yeah, so if I'm Grappha or if I'm Daiske, the build that I'm going for is guaranteed first place for sure, because even if I finish like 4, I won't get anything, right? So just go for the riskier strategy and go for the top one. The goal will be the top one. So we're going to spectate actually Grappha, so we can see if he can, you know, climb from top 8 to the top one.
Yeah.
We'll spectate Grappha and Mapo. We're going to spectate Mapo because he has a interesting line here with 13 points, so we can still make it to top 3. So yeah, those are the 2 players we're spectating. We're just going to get ready with the lobby and start the last round. So yeah, this is the last round, guys. Again, if you want to join the giveaway, so just type hashtag Prime again in the chat to join. Hashtag Prime again to join. So Daiske, as you can see, Daiske doesn't have a tavern pass and is joining the
round. Also, Oiger, you could spot them on the
chat. Oiger is also participating because they don't have. So again, 2 players here. The top 8 players here doesn't have a tavern pass. So it's Oiger and it's Daiske. And the rest of the players have a tavern pass. So yeah, good luck. So Ren saying, who are we going to spectating? You know, yung bet niya. So yeah, we're going to spectate again Mapo on the left and Grappha on the right. So we'll see the bottom one if we can rise from the
bottom.
The bottom. So okay. I think
they're on the game now. We okay, can spectate them now.
And spectate. Hopefully we can still see the hero selection here.
Let there be Lord Barov. Grappha. Grappha have the Lord Barov.
So, let's see.
No more luck. Nice. Wow. Grappha went for a wager. That's nice. Props to him.
Okay, so that's nice.
No more luck, Grappha, right? Kara, no more luck.
No more luck, right? And then Mapo here, selecting Lich King, Shadowwalk, Patchwork, and Pyramid. So I think, yeah, Mapo will go with the Lich King, of course. And let's see. Grappha, this is exciting. Going for the Lord Barov. So is he going to wager turn 1 or not?
Don't be like Enli. Oh,
no.
Wager 1 out of 7.
Andrew, if you don't have a partner, I said, if you don't have a partner, just search in the groups or in Discord. So, yeah.
So, Kara, kindly...
Okay, McNavi, do it with...
Kindly run down the heroes on the lobby. Heroes.
Okay, so for Lich King, Mapo using Lich King versus JudeQuinn, who is using the Yog. And then, Grappha using the Lord Barov. Adi Oni, Captain Hook task. That's interesting. Weatherlight using Millificent, Mana Storm, the mech one. And Switch with another good hero pick here, Kael'thas. Daiske with the Nosdormu. And Sir Finley for Oiger. choosing the map, the Elise hero power. Okay. So Oiger did the major. I just saw his screen. So he bought a token, do the wager, and won in round one. But wow. I didn't know the options. They didn't know the option. So now
that's
Dice versus Mapo. He selected Mapo for sure because it's Lich King. So it looks like it will be another 3 coins for Grappa here. So even if Grappa doesn't win, I'm just happy that we're spectating Grappa.
Because I'm happy Lord to Barov. Showcase Lord Barov on the stream.
Nice Grappa. So now Mapo is who has the wager of Grappa versus Nosdormu. Looks like he's going to win here. Yep. So another 3 coins for Lord Barov.
Wow, he's a good gambler. He's a good gambler.
5 coins here. Can for sure gamble again. He can also level up or play it safe and buy these 2 demons, which is also very good.
But he needs a wager, right?
Of course, he has 4 coins, so he will wager for sure. Let's see.
Mapo versus Mapo Oiger. That was Oiger, a big pick. I don't know. I'll chat Grappa to pick slowly. Pick slowly.
The wager. I think he's going to go for Lich King because he knows that Lich King has a good hero power. So, Lich King is the best bet. So it's kind of an advantage for Lord Barov if he's selecting Lich King because
of the early game advantage.
Yep. So it's easy pick for him. And yeah, Lich King winning again. So grab another 3 coins for him.
Wow, that's 3 turns in a row.
So he's going to buy this and then probably level somewhere here.
Miracle
versus
Miracle run, let's go.
I think he's going to pick Yogi strong. Going to pick JudeQuinn. Yeah. Early game, Yogi's very strong. Do you think he should level here for 5 gold?
If he can.
Yeah, he can. Yeah. So yeah, he's going to pick the level. What?
Oh, okay.
Oh, no, he's going to buy.
So he's getting super aggressive because that's a good stats for a 3/4 body for a 2 drop. I mean T2 minion. So he'll be dealing a lot of damage if he wins here.
Probably because he knows that Kael'thas is also strong.
Yeah, that's true. Maybe it's exactly for the second cycle of the hero power of Kael'thas.
Yep. So if he didn't bought the 3/4, probably he
could draw or lose, it,
right?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's a good turn for Grappa.
Let's see if Yog won.
Yog won 4-0.
Oh, no, okay. I think Ellie should have a counter for the Lord Barov wager. Should create a counter, right? How many wins?
We'll just have to announce it. 4-0 for the wager.
Okay. So, Grappa here, Switch versus Daddy Oni.
Oh, this is close one. Maybe Switch, Kael'thas. Because he saw that Switch is kind of strong when he faced
Who did he pick?
Oh, I missed it out. But I think Switch.
But I think it will be Switch because the Oni hero is not that good. Let's see. And Lich King here, Mapo, has a possible triple next turn. So that's very good for him. And while Grappa here winning all the
wagers.
It will be interesting later if Grappa will bet on his own.
If
it's actually possible.
Yeah. If you're confident about your composition, bet on your own. Very interesting hero in the battlegrounds.
Yep. Exciting hero actually. I showed this to you only right previous yeah. preview of the Lord Barov. So did he lose?
Wait, let's see.
Oh, he lost. So it's a tie. I think he lost.
Switch versus lost. It's a draw. So
draw, having a draw with Lord Barov is actually a loss for the wager.
Yeah. So technically hero power is 33% chance and it will increase depending on your information about their comp, right? The base is 33%.
So wait, why did he use one coin? Is it a miss? Or is he going to buy something?
I think it's a miss.
Okay.
Oh, okay. So coin wager.
Ano, he planned. So, he's going very aggressive here, Mapo versus Switch.
He picked Mapo, I see.
I think it's Mapo.
But I think Mapo just leveled, right? Yeah.
No, Mapo level. Oh, yeah. Ah, he leveled. He didn't still triple the golem. So,
yeah. So, I'm not sure if Grappha is paying attention on that.
Agree. I think you need to also pay attention no, on that if he level or not. Because if he level, for sure, he'll likely lose.
Add the power level on his board, yeah.
I think you can still tie or no.
So we can see so no. So 4-1-1 for yeah. for Grappha. We'll record the draw. So 4-1-1.
Yeah, the triple here with the spawn.
So both Mapo and Grappha have a chance to triple now.
Yep, both players chance to triple actually. Yeah. Let's see. Got Sneed, Spiegel, and Morozond. Went for the mech.
Then
because also of, probably report? Because of the +1/+1.
And maybe he'll give the... Is it better to give the hero power to the Sneeds or still at spawn of Nuzot?
I think in the Sneeds, for sure.
So he went for the
then
Sneeds.
Then here, yeah, he bought the Grabber. Only one golden.
Mapo versus Daddy only on the wager.
He picked Mapo.
Okay.
Pick Mapo.
So he's trusting his earnings to Mapo.
Actually, I think it was 3 or 4 times he bet on Mapo already for this game. So now, I saw Lord Barov freezing the juggler earlier. So, he's probably going for the demon's build yeah. here. And easily winning this versus Switch.
So, Switch is at... Kael'thas, right?
Yeah, and it's down to 12. Oh no, Switch. Switch again needs to finish top 5 at least for him to for to secure his top.
So Grappha thinking Mapo. He should think Mapo every time he wins the wager. So 5-1-1.
Do you always wager first or what do you think?
You should wager on the last 10 seconds because you have to think about the turn of your opponents also. Consider if they tee up. But it's kind of hard to check the seven players because the wager is random.
Because you usually just check the opponent you're facing. Yeah. So now,
Mapo, JudeQuinn.
This will be a close one. Top 1 versus top 2.
Yeah, and we'll be seeing Mapo again facing... This wager is being broadcasted on the left side of the screen. He still bet on Mapo, I think. So 4-1-1 is the record. 5-1-1. 5-1-1 is the record.
Can't bet on your own unless it's the final as per Clyde's Strife.
Or maybe
actually, you can.
Last time you only have 5.
When I tried it, we're just 5 in the lobby.
It will happen when it's less than maybe 6 players.
Oh, okay. Because when I tried it, it were just 7 on the lobby. So let's see if Grappa will win the bet.
So you
the
got,
left side of the screen.
You got actually, the dragon build waiting for a Nadina Razor Gore or Kalekos. Wow, Kalekos is dropping on Lich King's board, but Yog needs that assist board.
Lich King will win, right?
Yeah, thanks Mapo. Thanks Mapo for the gold.
Oh, one down, daiske is out.
Oh no.
So daiske is out.
And maybe daiske and oiger.
Out. Okay, so two players. Oiger is out, so that's...
So it's like...
0 points for oiger.
So it's like daiske is on a 7th or 8th spot in our leaderboards after that. Also oiger, if I remember correctly. But we'll see later after this round.
So Daddy Oni also hanging for his dear life here with just 4. He also needs to finish top 4 here to be able to get the winnings for the top 3 places.
Yes.
So,
but he'll be facing Rich Lord Barov with a demon comp. Will Mapo go for a Tide Razor here? A boat? Yep. I think this is a boat.
Yeah, I think it's boat. And then hero power the boat for sure.
Grappa is hoarding his lot of coins, but I think he needs to play some of it now. Did he wager? Yeah, oops. Mapo versus Weatherlight. Who will he pick?
Mapo. I think it's Mapo. Lord Barov's best friend is Mapo. It's always Mapo.
Yeah. It's like they're playing on a duo. Is it 6-1-1? 6-1-1 record?
I think... Okay, that's a very good trade for Lord Barov. The 6-6 into the 11-6. And another good trade.
And I think
this will be a tie.
No.
Oh no.
He lost to Daddy Oni.
So Daddy Oni survives. Very crucial.
Hanging on his dear life.
But Mapo here looking like he's going to lose.
Unless he could snipe the Herald of Flame. Oh, this is a draw. Oops. Too bad.
Oh no. Yeah.
Too bad for Lord Barov. 6-2-1. What an amazing record for
Rager. So he chose to go to level 6. He chose to go to level 6 now. Because he has a lot of coins already in hand. But still, the board doesn't look
It's not that strong.
So he got an imp gang boss.
Yeah, good
that's
for
a
Soul
demon,
Juggler.
But...
And good for Soul Juggler.
Yeah.
He needs to survive one more turn. Hopefully, he could survive. Because if he receives more than 20 damage, that tavern up this turn is detrimental for him. He could have upgraded his board state safely.
Mapo versus Switch. Go for Mapo. Best friend Mapo.
Mapo won a lot of time. See, he picked Mapo.
But Mapo lost earlier when he bet. One more thing here, Mapo as Golden River there on the left side of your screen.
Yeah, right? If he throws it for the Golden. And he's going for a Reborn Tide Razor. Maximum scam. Facing Switch.
Wow, so this is actually crucial. Switch needs to win this.
I think Switch... And maybe he could survive depending on the scam level. Oh no, this is a scam level, high scam level from Mapo because of the dead Admiral Eliza.
But one thing to notice there, Enly, the boat didn't resummon because there's no board space.
Ah, yeah, yeah, that's true.
So it's actually good for...
Waste of hero power.
Good for... Yeah. But is this enough for lethal?
Yeah, enough.
Yes. Oh.
So switch,
drop. So let's see if Daddy Oni will drop here.
Yes.
Along with switch or
so
not?
So switch is on the fifth okay, place.
So, yeah. Yeah, switch finishing fifth place here. I think this score is good for maybe top three.
Yeah,
so, but Grappa here, we still have a chance for the first place as long as we finish first here, but, I think. Let's see.
It's kind of hard because the remaining people in the lobby scores good scores too. With Mapo and JudeQuinn and Weatherlight. I'm not sure if he could, he could reach this, but the Lord Barov performance is super great here. Demonstrating how powerful Wager is when you have a best friend like Mapo. Seven to
so
one.
Now, super, I have a lot of points, okay? Just for the viewers, the what do you call this? The hand, there's also a hand issue with Lord Barov, so you need to call this play your cards or else
your
it will
coins.
Not get the coins. Yep, will not get the
Jude
coins.
Jude Queen
versus
so
Weatherlight.
He chose Weatherlight. He trusted the one with higher HP. Jude Queen at four, Tavern 4 and Weatherlight at Tavern 4. So they're going for a top 4 game plan because they're not going for the higher Tavern, right? That's the usual game plan if you want to play it safe in a tournament.
Yep. So Mapo here choosing to...
Oh no, he's facing his best friend. We didn't highlight it.
Really?
I mean Mapo versus Lich King.
Yeah. Sorry. I thought the Wager is Mapo versus
Grappha.
I think he's dead.
Yeah, he's dead. Good run for Lord Barov. Too bad his best friend killed him for top 4, which guarantees him not getting the top 3 spot, right?
Yeah. So JudeQuinn finishing 4th place. And now, it's Mapo versus Weatherlight.
So I think Weatherlight...
Yeah, it all comes down to the
Weatherlight
top 2 players.
Already... guarantees the top 3 spot. I'm not sure about Mapo. So this is gonna be a long fight, I think, unless some scam happens on Mapo's board.
Grappa getting 6 points there, and the other one, JudeQuinn getting 4th place, right? So that's 5 points. So Mapo here still very healthy at 33 life and Weatherlight at 16.
And it is super advantageous to Mapo because of the Reborn Maex na. Plus, there's a lot of death rattles coming from him with a golden baron on his side. It would be nice if we could see a triple ties on first so we could have another lobby with them playing
next
around each other.
Among us. So let's see here. Let's see the win percentage. So it's 56%. Actually, 56% for Weatherlight to win this.
Oh.
For Weatherlight. Yeah. I think the statistics doesn't count the death rattles.
Yeah, and the power level of the death rattles. Maybe the egg is considered, but the boat and all Sneed's old shredder is not counted. Like this.
It's lethal, right?
Yeah, lethal with razor, even popping.
Oops. Yeah.
Yeah, so end of our four rounds of Battlegrounds. So we'll jump into our scoreboard and check who will win this tournament, right, Cara?
Yep. So right now we're just tallying the scores. Let's see. Who got the first place? Mapo finally winning a lobby.
Yeah.
So best MMR player finishing strong. That last one. So one thing I want to say that we didn't see any pirate comp. I also wanted to see some pirate comp.
Not full fledged pirate, but a gold grabber. We saw a gold grabber at the very least, right? With the switch.
Oh wow! Okay, so we have a tie in the first place, but we have a tiebreaker match. I think we're ready to show the scores, Enly.
Yeah, I'm already showing the score. Oh no!
Okay.
No.
Yeah, so it's actually on the first place is Switch and Weatherlight. But since the tiebreaker is the player with the most first place,
yeah.
So it's actually Switch who has two first place. So Switch getting the first place. Congrats. Congrats to Switch for winning the Battlegrounds Prime. And in second place, it's Weatherlight. Even it didn't finish
strong,
place in
yeah.
any of the lobbies. But yeah, consistent top four. It's 24 points. So that's 30 Blizzard balance, right?
Yes, 30
Blizzard
USD.
Balance. And third place for Mapo, which is 20 Blizzard balance. So climbing from top 5 to top 3. And the rest of the rankings here, 4th place for JudeQuinn at 20 points. The only 15 points, but on the second one, he got the first place with Jandis Bar of Pogos. Rafa here showing us a good one on the round 4 with the
Lord
Bar of Oiger with 12 points. And Daiske with 10 points. I wanted to point out that the last two players, those who doesn't have Tavern Pass, I'm sure it doesn't affect. It's just a coincidence. Because Daiske also finished top 2 in the first one, right? So
yes, that's correct.
It's just a coincidence. But yeah, here are your top 8 players for the Battlegrounds Prime. And congratulations to all the players here and to the top 3 players, Switch. Weatherlight and Mapo.
And someone from chat, Renz HS, Bayan, she's actually right. Lucky charm talaga si Andy. Because majority of our spectate from round 2 onwards, they're staying up to top 4.
Ah, yeah. And then we spectated Mapo, right? So, yeah. Mapo won.
So,
wow, 56%. For Weatherlight. What do you mean 56%, Aster? I think the percentage, but it doesn't rank, it doesn't count the rattles. So yes, I think we're ready to announce the winners, or let's announce again the knockouts. So for the knockouts, just register here in Mogul. It's open to all Southeast Asian region, so anyone can join. HSBG knockout. I think it's 64 players only, so reserve your slot. And then next Sunday, another tournament of Enly, the Battlegrounds Duos. So you need to find a partner. Register here on the form for the duos. Look for a partner. What else, Enly? Do you have any other announcements?
Tomorrow, watch Esports Akad Arena semifinals. Enrico versus Raz, then what else? Zels versus Usplash. So there are some of the student.
The top 4 players.
Yeah, semifinals. That's already semifinals. That's why.
Screenshot mo na. Congrats,
wait. I'll place the face of the other players too.
Sure. So yeah, we're just wrapping up the tournament. So if you enjoyed this Hello, Enly.
Actually, raffle also. Before we get the raffle.
Yeah, the raffle. Before we wrap up. We'll do the raffle later on. We'll just do the wrap-ups while you're still here. Follow Enly. Follow, subscribe to his YouTube. Subscribe to my YouTube. Follow AKG Games. AKG Games Philippines in Facebook. AKGGames.ph Twitter. AKGGames.ph in Instagram. Congratulations again to the winners.
Yeah, I think these top three are the top three MMR, top right?
Three. They're actually the top three MMR players. So, in the different order, because Mapo is first, Weatherlight is second, and then Switch is third.
Yeah, in reverse so order.
Weatherlight, Mapo. So, yeah, congrats! 50 USD. Ano na yun? It's an
standard order bundle. Na yun. Yeah, standard bundle.
Yeah. Or pre-order. You can save it, Rafa, for pre-order for next expansion. Which is coming up. Next expansion.
Really? It's so coming up? Again. Whoa!
It's close. It's close. But the team is nice. I like the team as well. So,
wait. There are 19 entries. Actually, it's one of them is you. So, I'll close it now. No more other additional entries. Closed. So, I'll draw now.
JudeQuinn. Subscribe to his channel, guys. JudeQuinn HS. Just search in YouTube. He's doing Battlegrounds also.
Yeah, JudeQuinn.
And from that solar player, so Daddy Oni, Grappha, Oiger, Daiske.
Thank you for joining. JudeQuinn and Mapo are BG players, right?
Yep. So we have our winner here, Hungary Camel.
Hungary Camel. He just followed 30 minutes ago. I'm not sure if he's here.
Hungary Camel, if you're here, say something.
Do you have Tavern Pass?
So, we'll just validating with a DTI representative. For Hungary Camel, if he has Battle Pass, it's to subscribe as well, for the YouTube.
Sure.
And do you have any thoughts, guys? Any thoughts for the tournament? Any suggestions, feedbacks? Delayed nga pala, so we need to type. We're just going to wait. But do you want to draw one more or?
Let's wait until 4:20.
Okay.
So let's talk about something else. Let's talk about Montreal. Montreal.
Let's talk about Montreal. So for Montreal. Yeah, go ahead, Andy. Ano masaya mo?
So for Montreal, apparently our three PH players already dropped on the tournament because Tope and Staz 0-3 while Madum got a 1-3 record. They cannot proceed to day 2 or later.
$150
yeah.
That's around how much, Andy?
That's around, if you multiply it to 50, so roughly 42k. I'm not sure if there's a tax. So not if bad. There's a tax, it's like 20% if there's tax, right, Kara?
Yep, 20%. So still not bad, right? So congrats to those three stars, Mapo and Tope. Mapo's brother. Tope and Madum.
Dapat we should have invited this top three on this.
So hopefully I think we don't have Madrid players yet, so hopefully guys you still have chance to
cause that's last grandmasters what do you call it perks is the invite. This one,
yep, the last invite,
and Tope is trying for Madrid but still have only one top 8 finish. Maybe winning will try for a ladder finish this month. Because last month he's trying. maybe now he could also try. I will draw another one, yeah, since
draw another one.
Hungary Camel is not here. So I will deny that. I won't accept. Draw another entrant.
Please follow the YouTube on the screen. Oh, wow. YouTube in LiPH. One.
Oh wow.
Did I win?
No, it's
wow, dice.
So it's like what do you call it? Consolation prize for him. He won a tavern pass.
We need to follow first YouTube.
For sure he'll grab this tavern pass, for sure. He'll do anything to get this tavern pass. So I'll accept it. Okay?
Sure.
Accepted.
Well, Andy will get your info, so your name and your email for the tavern sure. pass. But yeah, congratulations, Nerf Jandis. Gip Janus, Nerf Jandis daw.
Again, congrats to Switch, Weatherlight and Mapo.
Congrats, guys. And don't forget, next week, we have two events, guys. Please support.
Oh, support it again.
Pag-support nyo dito. Pwede na sila tayo mag-Tagalog. So, kapag pag-support nyo dito. Maraming salamat, guys. 32, I think ito isa sa mga pinaka-successful na community events.
Actually, highest stream ko na to. Okay. Average, kasi 20 plus. Actually, dito, 30. Mm. Yung last is the, ano yan? Yung Ashes of Outland early access, mga ganito rin yung numbers, but ang viewers nun marami, mga parang nag-retain lang from host and lurks from other early access players like Player HS, yun yung nagpa-spike sa akin.
Pero thank you talaga for supporting this stream, kasi ang dami nyo dyan, no? 33. I think because we also shared this, right, to the other communities. Hearthstone also posted, but yeah, nice to see that the players are watching here and supporting the players, although this is a invitational. I mean, top 8 players, pero you see you're supporting here. Hopefully the next one, the next two remaining events, so the knockouts and the duos, still support and watch the community events. So again, thank you so much. Appreciate your support.
Type 1 if you want Kara to reappear on duos.
Meron na pang tournaments. Nanalo ba ako? Yes.
Again, yung tavern pass will be insert on your account. Maybe later this month or next month, right, Kara? Because it will be directly from Blizzard.
Yeah, it will be directly from Blizzard. It will be placed in your account. Kung paano nila nilalagay yung mga packs sa account ko, ganun din yung gagawin nila sa Tavern Pass.
So, will take time.
Yeah, it will take time kasi we'll still need to finish all the other tournaments. So, we'll need to finish yung iba pang events. Then, we'll submit everything. So
almost
it will take time.
So, 2 months na lang. 2 months muna lang magagamit. But it's still a free tavern pass. Oh, reappear on the duo. Ah, Kara, you'll be reappearing on the duo.
Pero dapat na kinapakain mo. Joke lang. Eh, sige. We'll see. But for duos, for sure we'll have a stream, but it will be quite challenging, no? Kasi...
Oh.
I don't know.
I'll have to reconfigure the... the overlay kasi
most na nandito is okay naman na.
Mm.
So konti na lang.
So dapat ikaw nandiyan din eh para hindi ko napapalitan yung na may webcam back sa upper right.
Last words na Enly.
So yun.
Thank you
so much for this turnout kasi ang dami nga ng viewers as Kara said, hindi naman to magra-run without you guys supporting the tournaments. Yep. So, important talaga yun. Kita mo, si Kara, kita niya yung mukha niya. Masaya siya. So, most likely, Kara will ask AKG, let's have this again on next month or yung mga ganun. diba? Kaya yep, continue yep. supporting the scene.
We need the numbers. We need the numbers to ano to continue running the events. Kasi without the numbers, we won't be able to ano to continue with the community event. So yes, support, support.
So yun na lang, Kara, wala na.
I think that's it. May nagtatanong lang ng score. Ayan, sinend ko na yung ano.
Okay. So, so sa mga nagtatanong din na among
na,
us.
Nag-screenshot muna. And,
alin? Oh, teka, yung, mag-post ka.
Mag-post mo.
Teka. Okay na ba to yung white yung congratulations switch or gusto mong gawin kong yellow?
That's not,
okay na yan. Oh, post ka na. Wait, screenshot ko lang. Tanggalin ko na yung salamin ko para walang reply.